I have a new video for you guys because we are talking about a snake named Kevin Federline. He was once married to Britney Spears and they had two beautiful children. Since then, he has been able to make more money in a year than the President of the United States. He has a net worth of $6 million because of what he has made off of Britney's custody battle with him. He's benefited from this conservatorship, and today I'm going to walk through exactly how. So let's get into it. As you guys know, I have been covering the Free Britney movement on my channel. I actually just got this t-shirt from my PO box. Thank you so much, Jen. But we have been fighting for Britney's freedom because she has been trapped in a conservatorship for 13 years. And so many people have benefited from this conservatorship. One of those people is Britney's ex-husband, Kevin Federline, also known as K-Fed, who claims to be an American rapper, DJ, actor, personality, professional wrestler, and fashion model. This was literally all listed on Wikipedia, so I guess he does a lot of nothing because he's been benefiting off of Britney's conservatorship and their children because the amount of money he's racking in through child support is insane. Literally $40,000 a month. So today I'm going to walk through how this exactly happened. How did he get in this position where he has full custody and he's making a ton of money off of her, enough to where he's worth $6 million? So let's go through their history together and why K-Fed probably doesn't support Free Britney because he's making a lot off of this. Just to give you guys some backstory, so Kevin met Britney when they were young. He was 25, she was 23. They dated for 3 months. They got engaged and then they got married 2 months later. Literally like married within 5 months, which if that's not a red flag to you guys, I don't know what is, because at this point in Britney's life, she was 23 years old. She was on top of the world. Everyone wanted to be her, wanted to be with her, and of course Kevin was benefiting from that. Literally the following year they had their TV show come out, Britney and Kevin Chaotic, and that was a total wreck. It ran from May to June. It was very short-lived, and we got a lot of insight into Kevin and Britney's relationship. And honestly, it really proved to me, I was actually looking back at some episodes, that Kevin is extremely immature, and I feel like he is an opportunist who just, you know, inserted himself into Britney's life at the right time. Britney and Kevin actually met at a club, and it was supposedly love at first sight. He claims that's all it took for him to fall in love with her. And I'm sure, knowing who Britney Spears is, it was very convenient for him to be with her. Before we go any further in this video, I do want to give a quick shout out to Real Cocky on Twitter. He is someone who I have become friends with through the Free Britney movement. He also did a thread on Kevin Federline, and today we're going to be following through that thread and pulling some information from his research because he did some great work and he showed how Kevin pretty much took advantage of Britney Spears. So definitely go give him a follow and check out his other threads and other tweets because some are hilarious. But what he was able to prove with his research was that Kevin had a plan. So pretty much his goal was to get primary custody of Britney's children. This is because Britney and him did have a prenup when they got married, and he was not going to get a lot of money from that prenup. So the only way that he would be able to secure money from Britney Spears is through the children. So he set up a plan with Britney's parents to extort her for money and live a lavish lifestyle without having to do anything but care for their two children who already have nannies and such. But let's take it back to 2006, when Britney just gave birth to her first child, and there was a lot of press about Kevin at the time because he would leave Britney alone during long periods of time, and he was found cheating and partying with other women while she was funding it. Britney literally paying the bills and supporting everyone in her life, and they continued to take advantage of her. One of his relationships was with an adult actress named Kendra Jade, and their friendship was obviously more than just a friendship. There's a whole article written about this from 2006, literally detailing what Kevin had going on with this woman who's quite inappropriate and a major step down from Britney Spears. Like, not trying to shade her or anything, but like, you're with like the pop princess of the world, and why would you go cheat with any woman, like, at all? Regardless of what she does, because that part really doesn't matter. You know, I respect all types of work, but like, you're with Britney Spears. Why would you go and hang out with these other women? A source told this article that Kevin Kendra just had, you know, did it at their friends. And another quote says that, you know what, Kevin probably isn't with Kendra officially because they're just friends who have SEX, like, who just do it. And I'm like, ew, like, what type of friends just do it? I guess they're like that. But in my mind, that's more than just a friendship, especially when you have your children and you're supposedly with Britney Spears. Earlier that same year, Kevin was actually spotted with another woman and he was cozying up to this new girl named Sandy. Honestly, I don't know much about her, but there are several photographs of him with his arm around her and it was obviously a little bit more than just a hug. She's kind of giving me the Britney Spears vibes with blonde hair, but like again, she cannot compete because no one really can compete with Britney Spears. This was back in MySpace days and someone actually put together this little collage where they pointed towards her MySpace page and you know what? I guess she was just another groupie or whatever. I mean, at this point, Kevin, like, he's only famous because of Britney Spears. Like, he did not have, like, a successful career before her. Like, yeah, he had his gigs and he was working, but nothing like the power he had while being with Britney Spears. Well, everything ends up falling apart on November 2nd. It's actually really heartbreaking because this whole moment was captured on camera, but pretty much Britney is pictured crying after seeing incriminating info about Kevin on her friend's phone. They were supposed to reconcile over dinner together, but Kevin stood her up. 5 days later, on November 6th, she files for divorce and asks for full custody of her children. After the paperwork was filed, things got messy because the press were running with this story. Of course, they were taking advantage of it because they've been taking advantage of Britney Spears for her whole entire existence. But of course, Kevin Federline, the most immature person probably ever, decided to go and do something extra right after she filed paperwork. As you guys can see, he actually went into a shower stall in his dressing room at the House of Blues in Chicago, where he performed on November 8th. And he wrote, "Today, I'm a free man. Ladies, look out. F a wife. Give me my kids." And then he signs his name, Kevin Federline. Also peep that I had to block out that bottom word because he called Britney a B-word. Why are you about to call the mother of your children a B-word? Because she's holding you accountable for cheating on her and she's divorcing you? Like, oh God, I cannot. Also, if that was my facility and you wrote up on the walls after you were supposed to come here and perform and such, like, I would be livid. I would have you come back here and clean it off, Mr. DJ, rapper, model, actor, like, whoever you think you are. And honestly, I need to give this quick disclaimer, guys. I'm really not trying to, like, drag Kevin. It took me a long time to make this video, and there's a reason why, because I've made hundreds, I feel like, of Britney videos, but I've avoided Kevin because I don't want to drag the father of her children. I don't want to do that to her because these are her kids. This is the father of her children and she will forever have a relationship with him. And I'm actually like going a little easy on him today because there is some information I decide not to include in this thread, but like I need to hold him accountable. I feel like we can't ignore the fact that this guy is making $40,000 a month off of Britney Spears, along with so many others, like her lawyer who's making, he's making $10,000 a week. So he's also making $40,000 a month. Like there are just so many people profiting off of Britney Spears and she's been on a working strike since 2019. So some things need to be straightened out. And one of those things is Kevin Federline and his relationship with Britney's father because they seem to get along. But let's take it back to 2006 because November 8th, 2006, you know, Kevin decides to lawyer up because he wants to take full custody of the children and the case turns nasty. He hired a man named Mark Kaplan and this guy helped Kevin fight Britney Spears and win the children back. This article spells it out. Just one day after it was revealed that the pop diva filed divorce papers against the rapper singer and declared her intention to ask for custody of their two kids, KFed has contacted his own lawyers. His goal, to keep his two sons from living with their mother. Oh my God, that is so sick to me, especially hearing how like Britney Spears, like at the end of the day, her children are the most important things to her. Her kids are. And anyone and everyone just wants to take that away from her. The literal bit of joy that she gets in her life, snatched away from her by a man like Kevin Federline. As you guys know, Larry Rudolph is very involved in Britney's life because he was her manager back and forth. She fired him, rehired him, and such. Well, back in October 2004, she fired Larry Rudolph. But once she filed for divorce in November 2006, Larry Rudolph was suddenly brought back into the fold. Then her entire team started pressuring her to go into rehab. Larry flew her out to a facility in Antigua, but Britney checked herself out 24 hours later. Because I don't think that Britney needed to be put into a facility. They were trying to force her out of the picture so they could rearrange some things with her estate and money and stuff. And obviously that's my opinion, that's alleged, but like that's how I feel. Britney's even been open that she has never had issues with drugs or alcohol at all. And actually the staff at that facility came to the conclusion that Britney was suffering from postpartum depression after being taken off of Prozac. So there was no need for her to be checked into a full facility and taken care of like this. This article spells out what happened. Britney Spears feels totally betrayed by her mom, her soon-to-be ex-husband, and her former manager. In short, she claims that she never had a substance problem, but was railroaded into. Sources tell TMZ that Lynn Spears, Kevin Federline, and then manager Larry Rudolph all pressured Britney to check herself in. We're told Spears acknowledged having emotional problems after her second child was born, but strongly maintained that she did not have any substance issues. We're told eventually that the professionals believed that Spears was suffering from postpartum depression, which was made worse because she stopped taking Prozac. She was also emotionally crumbling because of a messy divorce and intense media scrutiny. Nonetheless, multiple sources claim that Kevin threatened to go public by going to court to wrestle custody from her if she didn't go to rehab. Sources say that Spears could not withstand the pressure from her mom, Kevin, and Larry Rudolph, so she checked herself in to Promises last February. I find it really odd that Kevin was all so involved with her going into rehab and claiming he's going to go to courts and fight her if she doesn't. I feel like it's almost worse for Britney to go to rehab because it's like admitting a problem when she doesn't actually have a problem. It's just all these people pressuring her and forcing her to go to a facility so they can, you know, benefit off of whatever they're about to do, schemey stuff behind the scenes. So then Britney checks herself into Promises Rehab in Malibu. But then, checks out less than 24 hours later. You might ask, why would she check out 24 hours later? Well, literally, Kevin Federline and his lawyer, Mark Kaplan, saw this opportunity of her checking into a rehab facility as a chance to go to the courts with an emergency hearing to discuss the custody of their boys. Britney's cousin Allie, who was very involved with her life, if you guys have not seen my video about Allie, definitely go check it out. Well, she goes and she picks up Britney and they drive to meet with Blair Burke, who is a criminal defense attorney. But why would she need to meet with a criminal defense attorney? Did Britney know that she was being set up? Well, hours later, Britney drives to Kevin's home where he denies her entry to see her children. Her parents were allegedly inside the house. Britney then shaves her head and then checks into the rehab facility for a third time, completing her 30-day program at Promises. Oh, that's so heartbreaking. Oh, I feel so bad for her. And you guys know, the shaving head moment is something I will never share on my channel. I think it's still, like, inappropriate when people share it and bring it up. Like, I don't even like to bring up the instance itself because I feel like, why do we need to beat a dead horse? Like, it happened. Whatever. Move on. Like, can you not respect someone's mental health? But, of course, with all these factors and everything in her life, like, everything must have felt like it was crashing down. And she had no winning. There was no chance for her to win. There was no opportunity out. She was literally trapped, and every single person in her life was taking advantage of her and getting whatever they wanted out of the situation. After Britney's big incident and she went into the facility, her father decided to go around to the media and start trashing his daughter, I guess to make himself look better or to make her look even worse, going around and telling folks that Oh, Britney is a sick little girl, Daddy says. James Spears told Fox News that the troubled singer is a sick little girl. We're just trying to take care of her. And other than that, I have no comment. Of course he doesn't. And of course he credits the monster, Larry Rudolph, for saving Britney's life and convincing her to go to rehab. Probably scheming with Liam Taylor, Larry Rudolph, and all of them to get her into rehab so that they could do all of the paperwork, the court filings, and take over her life. As you guys know, Britney's mother has been in and out of the Free Britney movement. She seems to be more in nowadays, but she did release a very controversial book back in the day, Through the Storm, I believe that's what it's titled, and there's a little bit from the book where she writes, "Right before Britney went into Promises, after she shaved her head, I got an anonymous call from a man while I was driving in LA. He said there are planted in Britney's Malibu home. Then he tells Lynn that there's pretty much a full-blown conspiracy going on between Kevin and Britney's assistants because Kevin wants to make Britney look bad and make her look like an unfit mother. This is something that Lynn literally shared in her book about her life and, you know, dealing with Britney Spears and that whole situation. So I feel like that is overlooked and we aren't paying enough attention into the crimes that occurred before Britney was locked up in the setup. Honestly, it was such a setup. And Kevin was right there along with Larry Rudolph, Liam Taylor, James Spears, and all the others getting ready to fill their pockets with Britney's money. Later on in Lynn's book, Through the Storm, she clarifies that the man who actually called her on the phone that day was Sam Lufty. So if you take what Lynn is saying in her book along with what Sam said during that call, you put two together, you could assume that Sam was actually working with Kevin and he was fully aware that they were putting these substances into Britney's home to make her look bad. It's like this situation gets messier and messier. And then at this point, Britney is released from her 30-day program and she immediately serves her mother with a fake restraining order, telling her to stay away from her and her children. Lynn also claims that when Britney left rehab, she was really upset with her. Quote, "Her anger at me had not cooled. In fact, she refused to speak to me, and our estrangement lasted for an excruciating 7 months where Britney did not talk to her mother at all." Can you imagine being in that position where you just can't even trust your own mother? Like, I feel so bad for Britney. I seriously feel like I don't know, like, anything worse that people can go through. Like, I feel like this is just so tragic. And, like, when your mom fails you, your dad fails you, your ex-husband, like, the father of your children fails you, there's literally no one there for you. And you guys know, like I mentioned, Allie, her cousin, she seems like she was there for Britney. I mean, I can kind of see how she was maybe an enabler, but I really do feel like she always had Britney's best interests. And there's actually a clip that was going around recently where Allie was being interviewed, and it was very clear to Allie that she thought this whole conservatorship mess would last for a month or maybe a couple months at most.
When was the last time you actually spoke with her?
Oh my gosh, like end of March of last year. Long time. It's been over a year. Sad. Yeah, I miss her. Not... I lived with her for a year. Neither one of us thought it was going to last this long. Right. It was kind of like, call you in a month when, you know, we go back to court, you know, and then it was just like on and on and on and on until it was, you know, permanent for now, so.
So obviously that's really heartbreaking to see that footage of her just like thinking that Britney, you know, is going to be out anytime soon. And it's just far from that because 13 years later, Britney's still stuck in her conservatorship. So October 2007, Kevin won full custody of their children. And then in 2008, only a few months later, Britney lost all of her rights. This pretty much ensured that Kevin was going to have primary custody of the children for the rest of their, you know, minor lives because she cannot, like, raise them, you know, with her conservatorship. Especially because, you know, her father has supposedly harmed her children, and this led to some more drama, and, you know, if James is, like, running Britney's life, then how is she going to be able to hang out with her children if he's controlling it? Like, it doesn't legally make sense, so, of course, she has zero custody of her children, and I don't think she ever really gets to see them. Like, even on their most recent birthday post, like, this past year, she posted random photos, not photos of them, because she probably probably didn't see them. Anyways, we were just in 2008 when Britney lost her rights and Liam Taylor and James Spears took over. But let's fast forward to 2018, because this is when Kevin starts getting extra money hungry. So in September 2008, Kevin and his lawyer Kaplan decide to go back to court and they ask for a raise in child support from $20,000 a month to $60,000 a month. Like, what children, like, what in the world are you talking about, sir? Obviously, he's just making money. Kevin claims that he brings in $3,000 monthly, while Britney was earning in excess of $34 million annually. Therefore, he's entitled to more of her money. So he's making, what, $50,000 a year doing whatever. On top of that, he's getting, what, $20,000 a month? That's a crazy amount of money. And he's claiming that Britney makes $34 million a year. Like, how does that make sense when Britney's net worth was recently released and it's only $60 million? Like, so many things aren't adding up. So he's claiming, oh, she's making $34 million a year, yet her net worth is $60 million. So she, what, has only been working for 2 years? Like, ugh, there's just so much grossness when it comes to the financials, and I feel like Britney has just been robbed empty. Like, is she gonna have any money left after all this is done? So, of course, this whole situation is handled publicly. Kevin agrees to thousands more in child support. I feel like he was trying to ask for $60,000 because he knew he wouldn't get that much, so he was trying to, like, do a high offer so maybe he would get right in the middle. But even $10,000 a child, like, a month, is just so much money that I don't really understand what's going on here. It's like, the children are in school, they're not in college, so, like, why would he need that much extra money just to maybe add to his own net worth? Well, Britney's father actually had some good questions. He asked for proof that the $20,000 a month that Kevin was receiving was being spent on the children. And Kevin's lawyer actually told Entertainment Tonight that James has no bearing on how Kevin spends his money, and James shouldn't confuse his function of being conservator for Britney with becoming conservator for Kevin. What in the savage? This lawyer that he has is a savage. And I think he has every right to know where the money's going, especially if you're asking for three times more, $60,000 a month, and you're gonna tell me that he has no right to know where the money's going? That's some BS right there. James and Kevin's lawyer, Mark Kaplan, decided on $40,000 a month, and that would be reasonable for Kevin, which again ends up being $480,000 a year, which is more than what the president of the United States makes, plus his $50,000 salary. So, like, Kevin Federline is literally bringing in like $530,000 a year, and most of that, 99% of that, is literally from his child support with Britney Spears. I'm sorry, guys, I'm not trying to drag the father of her children, but there is something extremely wrong with that number, and something just isn't adding up to me. I think that's an opportunist who has made a lot of money off of someone who's been put in a vulnerable situation. And of course, he doesn't want to free Britney. He wants to leverage what James is getting and get himself a little bit of that gold and make more money off of her. Something I do want to mention, and it's something I found very interesting, is that Kevin's children are actually very active on social media. This isn't Britney's child, this is Kevin's child. So no relation to Britney besides that being her, like, I don't even know if they're not step-parents, so I don't know what she would be. I guess nothing. Like, literally her stepbrother's mom. But anyways, they have been posting on social media, and it's definitely oriented towards Free Britney. So we know where Kevin's children stand when it comes to Free Britney, but I have a feeling that Kevin, like, does not support the Free Britney movement. Maybe he does publicly, but I really don't think he would, because if Britney is released from the conservatorship, I'm sure this would be renegotiated. I'm sure that maybe one day she can get custody again, which she really should be able to. But, like, does Kevin want that? I don't think he wants to lose his $480,000 he makes a year. That's insane. But I want to hear what you guys think in the comments below, because honestly, it irks me to know how much he's making off of her. And I feel like this guy is just extremely problematic, and he uses the press kind of like Justin Timberlake to his advantage to make Britney look bad, or to just make himself known and relevant or whatever, trying to flex the whole situation with child support and make that a whole thing because he wants to pressure James into agreeing with him. And then he got what he wanted, $40,000 a month. So I think we all can agree that there are some major problems here. The conservatorship alone is just so, like, unconstitutional and not okay. But this custody battle is just the cherry on top, reminding me how crucial it is to free Britney and get her out of this mess, because there are thousands of people who are benefiting off of her financially, because the lawyers, like James got a lot of lawyers, Sam Ingham, he's got a bunch of lawyers, and I'm just tired of all these people spending her money. She needs to be able to do whatever she wants with it, go live her best prairie life, and live with her children. I don't even expect her to ever perform again, and I'd be totally fine with it. I just want her to be happy and to stop being taken advantage of by Kevin, by Liam Taylor, by Jamie Lynn Spears. You guys know, if you have not seen my video about her sister has made so much money off of her, and she keeps writing expense forms claiming, oh yeah, like, I've never spent Britney's money. Well, then why are you getting all these expense forms written out and approved by Britney's team to refund you whatever your flights and other things, your vacations and such? So the whole family needs to stop, and they're going to continue being called out by me and others until they realize that this is so wrong and they need to fix it. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. As you guys know, I like to open little packages at the end, and I got this package recently from Pam, and I am so excited, Pamela, because you have been emailing me, and we've been going back and forth, and she's just such a lovely lady. She's in Massachusetts, and she sent me this package, and I decided I wanted to open it. What does it say? Oh, handle with care. Horrible attempts at crafting enclosed. So let's go ahead and see what she's talking about, because I feel like Pam is being a little harsh on herself. I love when you guys send me stuff, and I always like to open it on camera because, you know, I want to give you guys your moment to, you know, be on camera and have your thing. Okay, I love how this is put in some, like, a respironics box, like, for a respiratory something. So I'm glad you're breathing well, Pam. Like, that's a good sign. You got the good tool. And I'm using this tool from Nate, actually, speaking of tools, to try to open this thing. Like, don't want to break anything, but, oh, wow, the packaging sometimes, guys. You are better than Amazon, because Amazon just stays throwing my stuff. Ugh. But, yeah, this is kind of hard to get. I'm actually really scared of this thing that Nay got me recently because it's so strong, and like I feel like I'm gonna accidentally jab myself on camera one day and just kind of like disappear. Oh my gosh, so let's see what's going on here. Okay, I'm nervous. Why am I nervous? The packaging in this, I'm like, oh, is this a like, what is going on here? I'm kind of scared. Oh my god, I get really scared from things. I'm like, is there something alive in here? Okay, let's see if she included a card. It looks like it was wrapped with the pee pad, which is honestly, it's a huge pee pad. This is such a huge pee pad. How did you? I'm like shook by the pee pad. Okay, hold on. Here we go, guys. Okay. Ooh, wow. So much stuff, Pam. Oh my gosh. There's actually a little pen cap, too. I don't know if you like accidentally. Is there a pen in here? Or maybe you left your pen. I got your pen cap, Pam. Let me know if you want me to send this back. But let's go ahead and see what's going on. I see a note right here, SL04N. Aw, and you wrote it on February 16th. What's today? It's the 23rd. Actually, so that wasn't bad. Sometimes, like, it's usually a month in between or so. Please accept these horrible attempts at crafting. Forgive the shirt. Oh my gosh, you are too hard on yourself. All week, Pam has been like, oh my gosh, when you open this, don't be, I'm gonna be embarrassed, blah, blah, blah. Girl, do not be embarrassed. I'm just so thankful that you sent a little piece of this, and I'm gonna read the rest of your letter off camera. I'm actually really bad at reading, cursive. I will email you when the oh, you're making a Tumblr too? Oh my gosh. Pam, she's also so strong. She had some like health issues earlier this year, and I'm just so glad to connect with people who are just amazing people who are not only talented, but just have such great stories. Oh my gosh. So she sent me some soaps too. Wow, a little ASMR. So it looks like Pam sent me a bunch of soaps. Wow, a bunch of soaps. You guys know that I love soaps so much. This one is rose, which is literally my favorite like scent ever. I love rose so much. Rose and lime, I love those. This one, it looks like, I don't know what flavor it is, but it's got a little like St. Patrick's, which is actually coming up really soon. And then, oh my gosh, you need to let me know, Pam, do you have a shop so I can link it below? These are lilac, and the packaging is so well, like I can't even sniff these ones because the packaging is just so good. But look at these soaps here. It has soap written on it. I cannot believe that you made these. The ability to make soap like this. This one is so pretty blue. I don't see what it says on it. It's got like a design print, but I can't really tell what it is. But that color, holy. My eyes could never. Wow, you sent me so many soaps. And then here are two more. There's like a dark purple one and a green one. Wait, what? This one says something on it. It says, homemade, 100% handmade. Wow. Thank you so much, Pam. I really love these soaps. And honestly, I am soaped up. So I'm going to have them for a minute. Thank you so much for these and the packaging. Ugh, email me if you got a shop or something. I could include your email below. But like, these are amazing. I'm sure people would love to try them out because handmade soaps are bomb. If you have never tried them out, definitely go try them out. I'm gonna try to throw these on my bed over there. I'm like not trying to. Oh, okay. beautiful. I feel like Gigi Gorgeous, you know, she used to do that. Okay, and then we've got this shirt situation, which she's saying, oh, don't mind the shirt and stuff. I'm sure the shirt is amazing, Pam. Okay, so I don't know. Oh, a candle. Wow. Oh my gosh. This is so sweet. Orange creamsicle. Oh my gosh. I have to open it up and smell it on camera. You guys know candles are my life. So it's like the soy complementing the orange. Oh my gosh. And I believe you made this one, right? Like, Pam, again, how do you do these things? Like, this is literally, I make candles and all of mine look like a mess. This one, and it feels, the soy feels so good too. Wow, thank you so much, Pam. Now let's look at this t-shirt, because you have been telling me that you're so nervous about me opening this t-shirt. I'm sure it's just fine. Watch it say something really mean. No, it's not going to. A voice for, oh my god, that is, no, what are you talking about? You said, oh, it's so bad. No, this is great. What are you, I love this. Oh my gosh, so that's the back, and then the front has SL04. Oh my god, Pam. When she emailed me and she was like, oh no, it's not gonna be good and stuff. I'm like, I'm sure it's gonna be amazing. I was expecting like something with Sharpie drawn on it. And look at what you did. This is amazing. I want to wear this in my next video. I really love how it has the bejeweled thing on it. That's so awesome. How do you even do that? I guess it just like sticks onto it. And then a voice perfect. That is amazing. Thank you so much, Pam. I feel so grateful. And I'm also just so grateful to have been able to email you recently and just become friends with you. It's such a like a light in my life, especially because I'm stuck inside all the time. And I honestly don't talk to that many other people like outside of YouTube. Like I pretty much have you guys. So thank you so much, Pam, for such these sweet gifts. And oh my gosh, this shirt is rocking. I'm actually mad that you told me that was gonna be bad, because I got like all nervous and now I'm like, I love it. So thank you so much. You are so giving, and I really appreciate you guys. I'll see you guys in a new video soon. Bye, friends.